Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Sedi. So I know how much he hates the camera, so I just decided to ask him questions. And while asking him the questions, I discovered he became so engaged. For the first time, he was comfortable to continue the question and answer session.
Mama.
So this thing is on recording?
Yeah, I'm recording you. Babe. Okay, I have questions to ask you. First, you have to say hi guys to my subscribers.
Hi guys.
Okay, no, you're not ready for your video, but I know you're not feeling too good, but I have to disturb you today. Maybe that's going to cheer you up, okay? So, question number one. What's your name?
Why didn't you prepare me for this?
I did not prepare you because it has to be a shock. Question number one, what's your name?
My name is Zeph.
What do you think about your wife being on social media, like putting herself out there on social media, putting your kids out there on social media? What do you think? How do you see it? Do you...
I don't have any problem with it as long as you are doing it for the purpose of education, educating the public
and entertaining.
And entertaining. As long as you are doing it for educational purpose. Yes, I support it.
Because it's not everything that I put out there that is education. I also put out things that are entertaining.
Yeah, it's what you like doing, so it's good. Yes, but don't cross the line.
Right. What do you mean by crossing the line?
Don't cross the line.
Like, what's an example of crossing the line?
I don't have to give you an example. You're an adult. You know what you are doing and you know why you are doing it. I support you as long as you stay within the context of what you are supposed to do.
Okay, that's well. Can you ever get up one day, let me say, in the next 5 years, I'm hitting it big on YouTube, like, and you just say, babe, you need to stop YouTube. Can you ever do it?
Why would I ask you to stop YouTube if you are doing it the way we have agreed for you to do it? Why would I do that?
No, it has happened before. Like, somebody just gets up, no problem, nothing. The wife is doing well on YouTube and just tells the wife, you need to stop YouTube.
I have said it before and I will still say this. You know what you are supposed to do on the social media and you know what you are not supposed to do. So the moment you cross that line, it means that you're putting a barrier. So everything has to stop at that point. I will not. Because you have crossed the border.
Okay, let me ask you a question. This brings another question. Is that not being a dictator?
What are you talking about, dictator?
No, that's what I'm asking.
Listen,
if you have to tell your wife,
this is a passion that you have. You want to do this thing.
Yes.
But you are not doing it as a single person. You are doing it
as a
wife, as a mother. You didn't decide to do it on your own.
Really?
No, you didn't decide to do it on your own. Before starting this, you discussed it.
Discussed it with your partner.
I agreed. You understand?
Yeah.
And we spoke of what you have to do.
Yes.
How you have to do them is different. But what you have to do is what matters.
Okay.
So the moment you go out of that context, and you understand perfectly what I mean, the moment you go out of it, it means that you are no longer respecting this home.
The issue of you just getting up one day and saying that, hey, babe, I want me to stop YouTube.
Why would I ask you to stop YouTube?
No, babe,
when you
have
are doing
done
it. When you
men
are doing
have
it,
done
right?
it.
Correctly. Why would I ask you to stop it? Why?
No, babe, men have done it. Men have gotten up from the blue and told their wives, hey, I don't want it.
Okay, let me give you a point. Listen.
No, babe. Just imagine that you it happened.
What is the
and
reason?
And I say no.
There must be a reason.
No reason.
If you say
I don't
no.
want this thing again. It's the same like you get up one morning and you say, I don't want to drink coffee again.
Yeah, because you are tired of drinking coffee. Coffee, maybe the
okay,
coffee.
Okay, probably you're tired of seeing me on TV.
No, no, it's not about
YouTube.
Tired of seeing me on YouTube. It's the manner in which you are doing it. Listen. If this thing has to take all of your life, it means that it's no longer working. Because
what do you mean by all of your life?
Yeah, because you cannot be inside the house and you spend all your time on this YouTube issue. And the children are hungry. I am hungry. Oh, maybe we don't even spend time together anymore to sit and talk, you know, or even play with the kids, or even have, you know, some family time. You're always concerned. I will tell you, madam, I beg, reduce this matter because it's getting too much. And if you don't listen, 1, 2, 3 times, I will tell you to quit. Because that's not the agreement. YouTube is not part of my family.
That's true.
It's just an activity. It's
It's
just something that you like doing.
Okay.
And it's not because I don't like doing it that I will stop you from doing it. But we talk about it and we agree on how you have to do it. So if you don't want to do it in that way that we agreed that you should do it, for me what is important is my family, my children. My children is what is important for me. If you pay more attention to this thing than my children, then this thing has to stop. If you go out of that context, there's a big problem. I will just tell you stop.
Go out of that country.
This,
like,
all those gossip issues, calling people's name, I don't want. No. I'm just trying to remind you of it because.
Yeah, okay.
If you go out
of your niche,
yeah. I don't want to.
One day it happens that, okay, I just get up and, as the Lord leads, I start earning more than you.
My dear, there's no way you can ever earn more than me. That's,
yeah.
It's not possible.
Because
if you earn more than me in terms of salary wise, I'm going to go in a business and I'm going to earn more again. So just forget about it.
Wait, babe, like seriously, I can never earn more than
you. It's not possible.
Why do you think
so? It's not possible.
Why?
Well, okay, maybe you can earn more than me, but I will always look for an alternative. I will look for a way that I will add something on my income.
That's a good point. So if I earn more than you, you have to try to earn more.
Of course.
Just because you want to.
I remain the papa for this house, the man for this house. I have to take care of my family. I can't depend on you because, okay, earn more than me, but I will always look for a way to double, to bypass you.
Financially.
That's it. I know how to do these things. Eh?
I know, but what I'm saying is that, babe, look, if I get up one morning and I earn more than you earn,
that is very good.
It's a very good thing.
It's a very good thing.
Yeah.
But I will not sit. Allow you to
be, say, to be a financial head of
yes,
the
no, I will not do that because
you
I will
make
look
you
for
to
another.
Work harder.
Yeah, of course.
But it's a good thing.
Of course, that's what I'm saying. But I'm just saying that it's not possible because I will not sit and wait for it.
Okay, babe. That's what I'm coming out to another point. Imagine I have a very good job now, and I have to start traveling around the world. This job actually brings large sums of money to this house. Like, the money is real, no joke. All expense paid, our kids' daycare is paid, babysitting for the kids paid. My spouse has an allowance because of this job. There are jobs like that.
Is the allowance more than the income that I earn? But if you have to start going around the world,
you become my manager.
Your manager, I have to be everywhere where you are.
Okay, babe, you be my manager. I've not refused. You be my manager. A question for you. You said if I have a job that I have to travel around the world, you'll be my manager, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, babe, if I have a very big job, you'll be my manager. That's what you're telling me. You accept to be my manager.
Mm-hmm.
Just because your wife cannot be traveling around the world, and that you'll be her manager.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, no problem.
But with the salary, eh?
With the salary.
Of course. That is above what I earn.
That's above what you currently earn.
Mm-hmm.
And if the salary is not above what you currently earn,
then it's not necessary. Now you don't need to. You don't need to go around the world. What is taking?
But my own salary is very big.
Big how?
Okay. Example: you earn. Let me say for example, you earn 4,000 euros a month, and I have a job that I'm going to be earning 10,000 euros a month.
Then you will give me 5,000 and take 5,000. Then I can be going with you. Is that not what we are talking about?
No. Okay, I will pay you.
I say you are manager.
No, but you are the one who chose to leave your job to come and be my manager. I don't have to pay you.
Really?
Yeah.
You know that money is not what is important, no? That money is not. You know that I am the type of man that will refuse that 10,000 and tell you to stay home.
Baby, I know you refuse the 10,000 and tell me to stay home. But my question is this: you will prefer that instead of my 10,000, I should pay you as manager for
of
what?
Course.
For traveling around the world. I don't need a manager. I can manage myself.
Let's wait.
Okay, imagine.
Maybe the money can corrupt me.
Maybe the money can corrupt you. Okay, imagine the 10,000 euros I receive is coming with a maid to take care of our kids and all expense paid, everything for us, housing and everything. Our mortgage is paid. Okay, let's go to the next. Do you know that being my manager means you're going to be doing things like. Being my manager means you're going to be doing things like carrying my bag.
Eh?
Yes?
What do you mean by
carrying my bag? The greatest, even my phone, you hold my phone, you answer my phone calls. That is what it entails.
I'm not your personal assistant. I am your manager.
What is the difference between manager and personal
assistant? Of course, let me have to run your show. Let me have to make sure.
So, then I'll need another personal assistant.
Yeah, of course.
Why?
Why do you want to turn me to a boy?
It's not an issue of boy.
Manager,
you
need a manager and PA.
You will pay. Okay, no problem. So probably I'm going to pay you 5,000.
No.
Inside the 10,000 I'm paying. Then you will pay now a personal assistant to be doing those things.
My dear, for
because
10, 000,
you don't want to do
10,
it.
10,000 euros is doesn't work for living your family behind. How much do we earn this for a month?
Babe, that's why I've asked you a question. Mm. We're talking now about being running the doing the job of a manager. You pick my phone calls. I tell you to make appointments for me.
I'm not your PA.
You're not my PA. Then you pay for a PA because the money I'm paying you is not to be flying around the world for me. It's not a honeymoon. I'm flying around the world for work. Your job is being my manager. I have to tell you what I want.
No, my job is being your manager.
To manage me.
And listen.
To manage my career.
And those people that are taking you around the world, they have to come prove me.
Through you.
Yes, that's the job of a manager.
Ah.
Mm-hmm. I'm not your personal assistant.
Okay, then you will pay for a personal assistant because I don't need a manager.
They will pay for it because they want to take you. They need you. Mm-hmm. That's why you are going around the world with mm-hmm. them. They will pay for all those services. Mm. I am the manager. They come to me. The manager is not the personal assistant.
If something happens and I become the head of this house financially.
It's not possible. Put up that thing. Something happens like what?
No, babe, it's possible.
Okay, in sickness.
No sickness. No sickness, babe. Tomorrow I get up and I fight. You don't earn anything. I earn everything. In
why?
Sickness.
Am I sick?
Babe.
Am I sick? And even if I'm sick, I have worked for it. I have worked for the years that I've worked for. I have an income. You might be having more than me at that point, but it's because I'm incapacitated.
Okay, no, mm-hmm. Just imagine that you don't have any source of income and I am the breadwinner of this family.
Why? Why would I not have a source of income? Why?
Are there men out there whose wives do everything for them? It's not like they are lazy men.
No, they are lazy men. They are lazy.
Is your wife a feminist?
Yes, that one is... 100% sure.
I'm a feminist. Really?
Yeah.
EG, I've never known I'm a feminist. Oh. To me, I'm not a feminist.
What are you then?
I'm a realist.
No.
Babe, I'm just being real. I'm not a feminist.
Let me tell you, my dear wife. For you, anything that concerns a woman, you never see, especially when it's about a woman and a man, you never take the side of men. You always protect women, no matter, even if they are not doing well.
Really?
You are always in for women. Anything that you hear concerning a woman and a man, you take the side of a woman. Of a man and a woman, whether a boy and girl, baby girl, baby boy, you take the side of a girl.
Okay, babe, I have this last question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, do you miss being married in Cameroon?
Yeah. I will see on camera.
Yes. Okay, you just miss those things that you get up in the morning, babe, what you have for breakfast?
No, not even all those ones.
Your
not even all
are...
those ones. It is only in Cameroon that men, only in Africa that men enjoy being married.
Really?
Yes, they feel the comfort of being a husband.
Babe, I cook for you, I clean for you, I wash your clothes, I basically do everything for you. So what do you mean?
Do you want us to say it on the...
Yes!
No. Listen.
Mm-hmm.
Mm?
Mm-hmm.
African men being married in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that are married in Africa, they have a more comfortable life. They enjoy marriage life more than the ones in Europe.
We go for holidays together. We spend more time together. Is that not what marriage is about?
That's what marriage is all about. But there's more added to it because
like,
when the man is in control.
Control and waiting.
Generally in control. Totally in control.
Like waiting.
Yes. Because now like this, I cannot just get up and tell you that I'm going to Yaoundé and you don't bring wahala, you don't start with your wahala. Why are you going to Yaoundé? Who are you going to see Yaoundé? It's not possible here.
You're traveling for business.
Yes. So those are the things that we miss.
Like,
and we miss the time that we go and spend with our friends outside in the bar. No,
okay.
What
kind of alcohol do you drink?
I don't drink, but let's just put it that way. There are times that I want to spend some time outside with some, you know, just be a man and talk some stupid things outside and laugh. And
it's good that she says stupid things.
Yeah, of course, but that's what makes it for the fun of it. But it's not possible because, you know, and maybe here you are not even the person that is holding me down, but the society itself, the nature of things here doesn't permit me to do. I don't have that time, you know. Who do I go to? There's no friend.
But you're among your wife.
Yeah, but it's not all the time I don't have to sit with my wife. What am I doing? Am I warming fire or what? It's not all the time that I have to sit with my wife. I have to be able to have time and go, you know? And secondly, there's also the point of my wife always thinking that I have to help her in the house. In Africa, it's not possible. When did that start?
Babe.
You know? They are family members, they are friends, they are neighbors to help. So I don't have time for all those things.
Okay, babe.
Those are the things that I miss.
So in Africa, you're not supposed to help your wife in the house.
How?
Why not?
When there are people who are ready to do it. That's why I say I prefer Africa.
So are you thinking that we'll probably go to Africa and stay in Africa?
Of course. If the country is stable, what am I doing here? I want to go back. And I'm almost getting, I'm in my 40s now. By the time I get to the age of maybe 55, 60, are we thinking of going back home?
So in conclusion, women should be careful the way they use social media. Married women should be careful the way they use social media, YouTube in particular, the way they involve their families. So this was an impromptu question and answer session for my husband, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. This is the point where I ask you guys to subscribe. Please click the subscription button, the notification bell, because he's going to be coming more on this channel depending on your comments. And if you guys want to see him on this channel, if you have questions for him, if you have topics you want him to talk about, he is going to talk about them, right, babe?
Sure.
You are telling my subscribers sure.
Of course. Yeah. As long as they don't come there to come and insult me. Anyway, I'm not scared of insult.
Yes.
I'm bigger than that.
You're bigger than that, actually. Mm, so
everything that I have said here is how I feel. It's what I think.
Yes, so, though you were surprised.
Yeah, of course. You can get me up from bed at any moment. I will answer the questions. I will still say the same
thank you
thing.
Very much that I surprised you and you did not say no, because normally I knew you would say no.